My first involvement in table tennis is, of course, from a player's background. I was a decent player. I quickly realized that my playing skills was not enough. I didn't train enough when I was in the crucial ages, 12 to 13. I quickly, though, became interested in coaching for various reasons, mostly for interest in sports in general. And I was supposed to be a soccer coach in the beginning. That was my kind of dream. And then got back into playing table tennis and got a very quickly, when I was studying university and so on, in sport coaching and sport leadership, and then got another opportunity to start playing again after holding a break for 1 year or so. And started in Halmstad Table Tennis Club, quickly became involved, and at the time I asked them to if they wanted to use me then as a coach. I was then hired as a youth coach and went on to coaching quite good players relatively early. I was involved with Jörgen Persson, obviously not his private coach or anything like that, but I was really fortunate as a young coach to have good players to work with, and that is quite important for coaching. I think that you quickly come up and learn the temperature dealing with good players. We had a number of good junior players also that I was able to push forward. Then moved on to Denmark, which was my first national team assignment in the Danish Table Tennis Union, and I also came there at the right timing with a new sport model that Denmark introduced. I had the opportunity to start again with a core group of players that really at the time responded to my coaching style, who at the time was, I would say, quite tough. I was quite demanding of the best coaches are. They demand perfection, and it also means that you have to step forward yourself. If you demand perfection from the players, you have to be there early in the hall. You have to prepare even harder than the players are. So coaching assignments as a job, as a profession, is really tough. You cannot do it as with your left hand. You got to do it with your full mind and your full passion in order to translate that to players. So I hope that's what I did when I worked with my players. In Denmark, it went on for 7 years, and I think in the beginning we realized that we had to invest more time in the younger players. So I was happy to work with Martin Monrad, Morten Knudsen, some good junior players overall, and of course in the end of my career in Denmark also Michael Mays came into the picture just as a little kid basically, but we were eager to bring him along, and it was not for my private pleasure as a national coach at that time. It was because we realized his level of talent, and then really brought him into the national team very early. And I think when you deal with young players overall, you have to understand that the environment will teach you a lot, and to get out and play on the international level relatively early, it will also teach you a lot. And a talent, one of the more important things with a talented player is that he will learn very quickly. And quick learning means that he can progress also quite fast if you sort out what he needs to improve and so on. And if the player himself is coachable, then you have a very good situation. And we've seen it also in my current profession working for the ITTF, how talented players quickly can advance. And one of the things that we have learned from the HOPES program obviously is that we drive the motivation and ambition up to a certain level very quickly. Normally this is something that the question will come if you want to play international table tennis. It may come when you are 16-17. That was, you know, before. The HOPES program, what it does is to asks those questions much earlier in your career, and that makes the program quite effective, I would say. We have seen a lot of players advance quickly and so on, get an opportunity on the international level, and I like that a lot. I think the different thing is today that if you want to improve on international table tennis, you always have to look what who are improving and who are the best. And if you look at the Chinese, you see that their physical abilities is so dominating today. So I cannot see a young player becoming competitive on world level unless you start quite early with physical conditioning and understanding maybe the importance of that. And that what I mean is not, of course, not the weight room with weights and heavy stuff, but with your body become an athlete. And I try to say sometimes that the Chinese are like gymnasts. We see the Japanese players here in Paris also improving their physical conditioning a lot. Although they are only 19 years old, they're very, very developed now physically, and that has such an impact. So I would spend time with my young players learning that very quickly, because physical conditioning, to improve that, is also about habits. The earlier you learn it, the more it will give the benefits. So that's definitely one of the things that I would spend more time. I think if we look all over the world, I believe that in Europe, in many situations, coaches, you know, and players, young players, spend a lot of hours actually playing table tennis, where they should cut down maybe some of the hours and be much more effective. My message to young coaches today is that it's quite important that you make up your mind relatively early. I think there's still a lot of opportunities, and I think would say that also a generation change on the coaching side coming relatively quickly now. So you have to see it as a profession first of all, and even if you're not well paid in the beginning, it all depends what kind of result you do. I mean, we're in sport, and that means that a good result, take a young player. Today, one of the problems, obviously, you have to spend time and be able to manage this player individually. That means you spend a lot of time on ball practice, on helping out with the physical conditioning part, and really building that early relation. That's something that I believe is important. But if you build that strong bond, and even if you're not recognized as a national team coach, I think the model of a one-on-one relation, a private coaching or whatever, is important. And it means that currently we have a lot of private coaches working with players. Until now, maybe the situation is not complete, so they cannot travel with the players all over the world because national associations and national coaches are taking over. I think what will happen, which is good for the coaching, for young coaches, is that the individual coaching relationship with young players in our sport will improve, and that means that national associations will eventually also start using several coaches, like they do in China now, where they have a strong relation of private coaches involved in the picture. So hopefully that will happen. And that would be my advice to young coaches, really, to if you have a talented player that you work with, you know, go the extra mile to make sure that they are on board and so on. Do not spoil the players, because that would be the worst thing, you know. But be strict and be tough, because I think that's something that eventually will pay off. One of the issues in the host program is obviously, you know, how to deal with young players and the family involvement. If you deal with young players like we do, we're looking at 12-year-olds, then family plays a big part. And generally speaking, I don't see much of a problem. I think that parent engagement in sports is just a trend that will continue. A lot of families invest money and so on for young kids and to learn sport quickly because they believe in it. And I think the passion there that comes from parents' engagement is a positive thing. Of course, in some cases, pressure, added pressure and so on is then becoming a negative thing, and over time that has to be learned. But I don't see many sports persons today developing without a strong parent engagement from the beginning, so I don't think there is any option. Parents in table tennis in generally, and if you go what we are trying to do with the host program, go to different environments where there is no tradition of producing good table tennis players, will play an extremely important role, but has to learn also relatively quickly what kind of role you can play. Obviously, it is in the initial stages maybe to travel with players out on the international scene and learning, but one of the learning functions for players traveling traditionally in our sport has been that you take care of yourself relatively quickly. And our sport in table tennis is also very friendly. There's a lot of environments out where you can feel very safe, and you can feel that the coaches will work for the best of the sport, not only for the best of certain players. So this is something really to trust, and I think the ITTF in many aspects are putting this in place. We're putting training center in place. We're working hard to have a level playing field. That means that parents, young players, should feel safe and absolutely 100% solid that an ITTF center will take care of the players. And I have no problem at all to recommend that maybe 14, 15 years old, then you need to be able to somehow spend time alone. Planning becomes very, very important in our sport and in most sports, and I think that parents in generally with young players today, with the number of opportunities that we present as a sport, need to first of all put up the ITTF calendar on the wall and learn, you know, how a functional calendar look like on an international scene. Secondly, they need to figure out, I think, and I was take the example of time management, where you say, okay, if you look at the 12-month year, how many days are my son, my daughter available for different kind of international competitions, national competitions. If the number is, and that is a number you will find out, and maybe in the early beginning it's 50 days, but you have to go up relatively quickly. If you're a competitive 14, 15-year-old player, you spend more days on your sport, and eventually that will lead into an understanding that this is becoming a full-time profession, and I'm taking the steps to be there because it's something you're used to do. Any young athlete that doesn't like to travel has learned to travel, I think, and that's the way the world looks like today in sports. So travel is part of it, and you have to count obviously the days, not only for the practice hall, but also travel days and so on. So learn that, it's a math. The math of success is to learn that, and I think if a young hopes player and their parents can understand that today, then there will be opportunities opening up in our sport that really can enchain or change your whole life, if that is the case, if you become a successful professional player.